Everybody, as Evicta has continued intrigue here in the Binding of Isaac Evicta Afterbirth Plus series, thank you everybody for the support on the like streak as we approach 100. We're getting there very, very quickly. Unbelievable. Thank you all very much, Mosh Pit. Yesterday's video coming in at 6,300 likes at the time of this recording, so I gave you double credit for that. Here's your meme of the day brought to you by the Brian J. Thank you, the Brian J. And thank you to all 380 some odd of you who upvoted it. So the title of the thread was, "Whenever Sinvicta sees a triangle, is this not Godhead?" Yes, thank you very much. I got a good kick out of that. Look, I like to clarify, you know, this is also not Godhead, but it is a triangle, kind of. D-Day is going to be Foxtrot, Victor, Golf, Quebec, Delta, Zulu, 7, Tango. We've got just not great stats, except for our movement speed, I guess, is okay. Our tiers rate of 9 is actually pretty excellent. We also start with Kamikaze again, which I feel like this is the second time in very recent weeks that we've started with Kamikaze. We also have the Solu. The Sol will deflect shots away from us. And by deflect, I don't really mean deflect. It will politely guide shots away from our body. It doesn't always work, and sometimes the strength of the suggestion is not exactly consistent. But occasionally, whenever you're fighting enemies that do spawn a lot of shots and fire them towards your general direction, it can mitigate some shots, and it's kind of neat whenever it happens. But for the most part, especially against someone like, say, Sloth, the soul is not going to do much for you. I would much rather have telekinesis. Yes, telekinesis guy. I know. But definitely, we've got a lot of room for improvement here. Would certainly enjoy having like some kind of damage upgrade. Bob's Rotten Head certainly wasn't the worst thing that Sloth could have dropped, especially given the fact that I don't want to use Kamikaze. Kamikaze will deal damage to us, and it does basically an explosive... Well, it's just an explosion that hurts us, essentially. It's like placing a bomb on yourself. It's not good. Suboptimal, I would say. So Bob's Rotten Head, however, will give us a throwable bomb that does something like this. And by that, I mean it doesn't give us a Tinted Rock that gives us a Soul Heart, but a Tinted Rock that gives us a Golden Chest. We also got a Wheel of Fortune card, which I'm not going to be using. And we start off with a Virus, which is a very good item, although it does slow us down a whole lot. So now I can't say that our movement speed is exactly legit. We do have the full charge over there as well that we can use against the boss. And unfortunately, we don't have any keys. I don't know why I walked that way. It was weird. I just got done recording with Huts, so I've been officially staring at the Isaac screen for quite a long time today, and I'm glad that I was able to get all that stuff done before I decided to record the Eden run, because, you know, more Isaac every day couldn't hurt. Look at that. We get ourselves the blood bag. It instantly gives us... Gives us back our movement speed. I don't know why I keep hitting fires, but I promise you I'm not moving. I'm not moving in their general direction deliberately. So I'm going to go back. I'm going to get that full charge and use the bomb on... Or use Bob's Rotten Head, I should say, on that Tinted Rock. I could have used it on Black Monstro, but honestly, even if it wasn't... Even if I did have a full charge here, I wouldn't use it on Black Monstro because of that Tinted Rock. I would use it for simply that. There's no boss that I can think of other than possibly Ragman that I would have used Bob's Rotten Head on in the Burning Basement. And Black Monstro is a little bit tankier than the other Monstros, although people seem to disagree on that. I don't actually know if the champion properties carry over like that. I think they do, but I'm not sure. So I'm gonna play the passive centrist here and just say that I think that it does. I think it does modify it, but I cannot verify. Inevitably, someone in the comments is going to do that for me, and I'll just go off of what they say. Cause that's the easy way, yuck. The channel might be a little bit light on videos for the next couple of days. My voice is still recovering from doing the speed run. Get yet another HP upgrade. And on top of that, I had to unexpectedly do vocals today, which kind of screwed me up a little bit. So the next couple of days could be a little bit rough. I'm strongly considering using Kamikaze for that other Soul Heart. Well, potential Soul Heart anyway, in that Tinted Rock. We know the Super Secret Room's there. Is it worth going in there? I mean, this could give us a key, which could give us this golden chest. But will this actually reach there? It does. He's done it. And we got our bomb back anyway, but we didn't get a key. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to place the Wheel of Fortune card here and hopefully get a key and another bomb. Okay, we got a bomb. Did not get the key. Still didn't get the key, but this is going to give us a lot of money, to which we then can possibly get a key. Okay, IV bag is far superior than Bob's Rotten Head. We're looking good here. We've had many a broken run start off like this. Okay, so I'm going to play the Judgment now in hopes that we get a bomb or a key. Preferably a key for now. Moon card gets us to the secret room, but doesn't get us a key. I think then we get the compass, which is honestly one of the best payouts you can get from Judgment. Okay. We're not done yet. We still got the curse room, and if all else fails, I can also just go use Kamikaze. We use this. Unbelievable, isn't it? All right, so that could not have gone any worse. We really, really wanted something to be of substance in there. Now it comes down to this chest. This one lone steel chest. And gave us a key. I am not, however, going to use it on that golden chest, nor am I going to use it on that one because I want to get into the store. And the ironic thing of it all is that there's not even a key in here. So, yeah. I'm going to buy the Soul Heart. I will buy the 3-cent heart because we can probably get something like that. Okay. I'll also buy this Stars card. Okay. Okay. All right. So to summarize, was it all worth it in the end? Probably, but it's hard to tell. Yeah. Yeah. Okay, I think that what we should do, let's go into the curse room, and then we'll use the Stars card. Okay, we got a nickel and a bomb, I'm fine with that. Stars card gives us Gnawed Leaf, which is an excellent item if we had an orbital, which we don't. We really, 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 really want to get some damage here. Computer's trying to freeze on me. Please. You got to see a little bit of a glimpse of the soul at work there on that that one Isaac torso shot. This pink champion's got to go. You'll see shots slowly kind of list their way away from Isaac, like that one right there, and that one as well. Again, the repulsion feel that you get from the soul is it's nice, but it's not guaranteed, dude. I freaking knew it was going to happen. As soon as I saw that fat Isaac move towards that way, I knew we were going to lose that heart. These are some pretty weird rooms, man. We need damage really badly. The Gnawed Leaf is going to turn us indestructible as long as we are not moving. And as you can imagine, having an orbital that allows you to deal damage without moving is obviously ideal for non-leaf. I mean, I wouldn't be opposed to getting one, of course. We got a Wheel of Fortune. Gonna go ahead and use this down here with this bomb. We did get that bomb back, along with the Soul Heart. Another Soul Heart. I will buy this other key. Is there a Red Heart in there? Half price one of that. There we go. We made 1 penny off of that. You never know. That 1 penny might come back to save us. So what you should do in this room is always focus on one of the Isaacs first, one of the fat Isaacs. What you don't want them to do is what they're trying to do right now, which is split. But thankfully, we have DPS high enough to where we can stop one of them before they can both get the flank on us, and that's when you're talking about Bad News Bears Town. A steel chest, we get the fish tail, which is good if we can somehow manage to get something that spawns flies. And now we got Limehorn. Isaac, we gotta do something about your face, buddy. And I had had another fun time recording with Huts, so you all will get to see the Sissy Trilogy. It probably should be Sissidry, right? Anyway, yeah, you get the conclusion of the Sissidry, where every item is sissy. And let me tell you something. If you want, I think that you're all going to be in for a very pleasant surprise and a whole lot of laughing. I just want to preface that by saying that right now, it's all laughs. We get Pageant Boy, which is really not what we wanted. And that is not Juice's Shadow. But I'm going to take it just to lock in the deal with the Devil Chance. But wow, this is looking rough here. We need to get help from the shop. We're officially at the point now where if we don't get damage soon, we're going to be in a lot of trouble. Or an orbital. I will take an orbital. I need to remember that I also have the virus. And now that I think about it, having the virus plus Gnawed Leaf is pretty good. I just wanted to see if it would work against Lust. I mean, it is poisoning him very slowly. I was hoping I can get it whenever he wasn't moving there, but I think the animation just stopped. He actually was still just pushing. So yeah, so that's one tactic I couldn't employ. That would be a very inefficient way of actually dealing damage to enemies, but it would work. I mean, the nice thing about that combo is that it would allow us to farm black hearts if we needed it, which right now we kind of do. And something else to think about is because we do have the IV bag, it would behoove us to try and farm some black hearts. That way we can use the IV bag. So like in here we should be able to nuke all of these and hopefully get black hearts from them. Yeah, they're all poisoned. We're pot committed now though. We cannot move from this spot. And like I said, it may not be the most efficient way of dealing with it, but as you did see there, we did get half of a heart. It's, you know, if we have to employ that technique, it's just good to know that we have it at our disposal. You know, that's kind of like a last resort sort of thing. Suffocation. No breathing. Yes. Yes, Papa Roach, that's what that means. You've done it. How do they do it? We get hot bombs here, which is going to make all of our bombs leave a fire behind them, a la Red Candidate. Or Blue Candidate, but usually Red Candidate. You thought I was going to get hit in that corner, didn't you? But this room right here is a worrying sign of things to come. Notice how none of these are elites. None of these are champions, and we are still not able to kill them under, like, 12 shots. Yep. Now, with mini husks here, this would be a perfect room to try to farm some black hearts off these little flies. There we go. Now that's what I'm talking about. When you talk about big time plays and big time players making them, this is what we're talking about right here. Oh, it's beautiful. I mean, who needs to move? Look at that. In all seriousness, though, this is the best way to use what the game has given us here. We're taking advantage of the virus and its properties of spawning black hearts on poison targets, and then we're going to use these black soul hearts to black heart bomb everything else, since we don't have our own damage to really work with. And by damage, I mean like our tier damage. So now we can just do this. And just get it back. So, yeah, that's working out very well. Let's see here. Don't forget, we can also use the IV bag, and especially if we don't end up getting a key. Although it does look like we're going to be able to bomb our way into the store. I can use the IV bag to our advantage as well with all those black hearts and get a lot more moolah. There we go. If I really wanted to, I could turn these into black hearts, or at least have attempt. The black heart generation is not guaranteed by the virus, but it's practically guaranteed. So we have fishtail. I definitely would like to take mom's purse. The blanket, of course, is going to be a given. I want to get those keys, if we can get a key. So let's go down to, I don't know, one soul heart. No, let's get rid of this rack. See how much we can get with this. Okay. Good. All right, so we're back up to full HP, except now we also have more money. We got two extra items. So essentially all those black hearts bought us two free items. And now we can roll the store, hopefully get a key so we can open up that golden chest, which is what I'm going to do right now. Well, I shouldn't do that, because if we see mom's key, we need to get that first before we open up that chest, just in case. Half price soul heart. What I could be doing is I could be theoretically taking all these red hearts and turning them into money as well. We get a health up, which I don't really want. Power pill. I'm going to stick with PH Dizzle for now, because I don't want to take starter deck yet. Okay, world card. Another key. We get starter deck yet again. And we get the jumper cables, which is good enough for me to take. And let's get our key back here. There we go. Got a luck upgrade out of here as well. Okay, so we got some keys. Hopefully we get a little bit of money and more keys out of here. Two bombs and 3 cents is not bad. I definitely want to get the battery. Okay, so we've got bits and pieces here of a promising run, but the fact of the matter still remains is the fact that we don't have any good stats, like true blue good stats here, and that needs to be fixed. So now that we have PhD, we can bomb the vanity here, Once I get a face that I'm fine with. Pretty fly. Power pill, and something's wrong. Power pill is going to be able to get us into the curse room for free. And then we can use the IV bag to get out of the curse room. Which didn't work anyway because we took too long to walk out, but that's okay. We still got money out of it. We have the Hoggler's Rune. I think that's that's right. The reroll machine's done. So hold on to the Hoggler's Rune in case we need it for the next floor. But damage is now at an all-time high for premiums. 2.95 damage is not stellar. And at 18 minutes and 27 seconds, we're finally ready to go on to the third boss of the run. Well, would you look at that? Oh, good. I'm just going to take the L on this one. We're going for Black Heart bombing here. Look how much damage that is, though. No deal with the devil, no surprise there. We get yet another HP upgrade, which I will not be taking. Well, I guess I'll take Old Bandage. Why not? Because it has a chance of paying out with a full red heart, which is good for the IV bag, and we're finally ready to head down to Catacombs 2. All right. Take a look at the vanity here. Never mind, we can't. We don't have any bombs. I'm going to go into the cursed room here. You also have to remember, every time we take damage, we're also generating the shadow leeches, shadow grubs, thanks to my shadow. But these are the runs that you got to get creative with. You really do. If you let a run like this kind of frustrate you to no end, to the point where you start making mistakes, then you're going to find yourself with a very ended winning streak. And make no mistake about it, this run is definitely streak-ending, but I have faith. I have faith in our ability to use the virus and the money that we can generate thanks to the IV bag. We can turn that into an actual huge advantage for us to ultimately win this run. But I'm not going to call it a one run. If you think this is a one run, I got news for you. I've got a rock that can keep tigers away that you should check out. Bad. We're gonna have to lose this heart. Oh no, maybe not. Actually got a key from that champion. Thank you, pretty fly. It's weird, these faceless grubs were making like the mini chub sounds when the little clicking sound when they charge. Which is odd, because they're not supposed to be doing that, because they don't have faces. It's kind of throwing me for a loop here. Okay, the blue one should be almost ready to go. Okay. Let's see if it was all worth it. I mean, Epiphora is not a—it's not a bad item. I shouldn't have shot those. I should have walked into those. Epiphora is not a bad item. It's just not one that's going to make a huge impact on this run, right now, anyway. I should really poison these bombs. See if we can get some HP here, or they. Oh yeah, you know what? The soul stops them from running into us. Yeah, that's right. Well, we successfully poisoned one of them somehow. Oh, here we go. There we go. I know that we poisoned this one, but I don't know which was the other one that we poisoned, but the soul kind of complicates that because the bomb flies act as projectiles and they will deflect off of us. Okay, there's one. Okay, so we only poison... I know we poisoned two, but only one of them paid out, but that's fine. It's still better than losing an HP in here. Got ourselves a bomb here. We have to take those options. Should I have waited before taking those options for the to see like if that was two diamonds? Yes, I should have. Woo, that was close. Yeah, I mean this is what we've been forced to have to do here, you know? I'm not saying it's ideal. I'm not saying I like it. But I will say that these are the steps you're going to have to take at some point. In one of your runs, for those of you who've been streaking, this is the level of commitment you got to take with preserving your streak. Pretty sure that was a champion. You know, it's got to be done. This is also a good room to poison these things on. So again, if we poison the whole lot of them, as you see right there, then they all can pay with a soul heart. Go get some more money. This is like, for as dumb as this looks, as silly as the strategy plays out, this is actually working in a pretty legit way with the IV bag and the virus. We're making do with what we've got to work with, and you can definitely admire something like that. Didn't think that was going to actually hit us. I'm going to keep holding this way on Epiphore just so we have our tears cap broken. But as you see, we need to get damage here. Thank you. You're seeing the repulsion field in work here. Now again, some shots may make it through, like that one. It's not the soul is not an end-all be-all defense. 68%, by the way, lol 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 lol. And we'll head on down. Woo! Mm-mm. And I forgot to go back and bomb the vanity. Oh, well. I mean, the best thing we can get out of pills by now is going to be, like, a movement speed or a tears rate, and that's it. And we've got Epiphora, which Epiphora doesn't technically count as a... In my opinion, anyway, it doesn't count as a tears up because, well, it doesn't actually technically give you any stats. I mean, it does when it activates, of course, but... Yeah, so we need to be a little bit careful here. We get Power Pill. But we need to be careful with our HP and the IV bag, because we don't know how much we have, thanks to Curse the Unknown. Power Pill is going to be very useful for poisoning enemies. This is a great room for us. I'd be stunned if none of these pay out with a Black Soul Heart. All of that should have paid out. I don't know if Game Kid, it's possible, not Game Kid, it's possible that Power Pill could have overridden. It could have taken priority over Virus, I guess. Let's just get the poison out there. Again, touching all the things, even if they do deal damage to us, like contact damage, it's still worth it for us to pick up all of those. For that very reason right there. And again, I don't care about damage. Blackheart bombing is just something that we just gotta do, man. We gotta do what it takes. And it takes what we gotta do. I mean, it's damage. I have to take it. It's not great damage, but it is damage. Now, a smart player would be using the IV bags with our red hearts to trigger our iframes, instead of us using our black soul hearts to do the essentially the same thing. But I think we all know that I ain't a smart player. Thank goodness we got black candle. We also are going to get mom's key. The black candle is going to purge and remove all curses, which I appreciate. It feels like the iframes are running out a slight bit too early when we use the IV bag. Either that or I'm just really sluggish today, which is possible because I didn't sleep very well. Did Victor not sleeping well? No. Never. Dude, what is going on with these flies, though? Like all of a sudden they just have like a huge aversion to standing next to me. I'm not going to hurt you, flies. I wouldn't hurt a fly. And we get Soul Heart's Cursed Eye, which I will not be taking. Fantastic. Okay. So... again, this is another good room for Blackheart bombing, or at least farming the Blackhearts for Blackheart bombing. Unless, of course, we don't get any payouts. That's also a possibility. We're praying for damage. Yes, I could open up that golden chest, and it could be Cricket's head, or it could be Steven. But right now, our priority should be focused on just taking down the boss and getting a devil deal here. Getting screwed out of our last one really hurt. Poison going. There we go. Beautiful. Beautiful. Alright, Monstro 2 shouldn't be too bad. You know, you could also just give a Sack Dagger. I would take Sack Dagger for this build, thanks to Nod Leaf. I mean, really, it comes down to Nod Leaf being the MVP. Without Nod Leaf, none of this happens. We'd be in a lot of trouble, that's for sure. Need to be careful because we applied the concussive effect to Monstro, which makes them erratic. And the Holy Mantle effect that you're seeing right now was given to us through the blanket that we got in the first store. I'm just going to keep holding in the same direction. Just let Monstro come to us. And the reason why I'm holding in the same direction is because I do not want to reset the Tears Up bonus from Epiphora if I don't have to. So what Epiphora does is it will maintain a stacking tears buff as long as you're firing in the same direction for an extended period of time. If you let go for whatever reason, it starts over. So right now, again, utilizing what we can to increase our DPS. Okay, pray for a good devil deal here. You know, it's a guppy item. It does work with fishtail. But IV bag is IV bag. Man, this is tough. I think you gotta go. I mean, we've gotta go with Guppy's head. That's the only way. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use IV bag down to like 2 soul hearts. Get maximum amount of money out of the soul hearts that we farmed up and are now wasting. I mean, not wasting, but spending. So that puts us in a better position to buy on the next floor. This is Depths 1. So as long as we don't get a greed fight in the next store, then all this will not be for naught. And I guess I will take the safety pin. And we'll head on down. Yeah. Okay, there is no greed fight because we see a mini-boss on this screen. I think we should go make a beeline straight for the shop and the item rooms. This room is just a giant bummer. We can do this, Isaac. So that was Jumper Cables respawning a full charge for us. I mean, technically, it only gives you one charge. But every 15 kills you get with Jumper Cables gives you a one charge. Not a full charge, but one charge. But since our spacebar item is a one charge item in form of Guppy's head, it will give us a full charge. Nice. And remember, every time that we use Guppy's head, we're also generating double the amount of flies thanks to our trinket, which is Fishtail. The secret room's below this room here. It's right, you know. Okay, I'm going to black heart bomb this room just because screw this room. Okay, we got our heart back. Good, 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 good. We get the wafer, which is huge for us now. Now, the wafer makes things a little bit interesting because now we don't have to worry about taking full damage from champions down in the womb. And that opens up our black heart bombing possibilities. And we do get a rollable room here. So let's buy the keys. I have the full charge to get our flies up. We get Diplopia as well, which Diplopia I'm going to buy but not use right now. Try that again. And try that again. I mean, they call it a streak for a reason. Double steam sail again. Which might be the first time I've ever seen that happen. So now I really feel vindicated about our choice to leave IV bag behind. Okay, things are working. It's certainly going. This. Boon card, okay. So we don't need money anymore. And with double steam sail, that means that we can just take whatever we want. We get Jar of Flies and Charge, baby. Now, Jar of Flies is a superior version, in my opinion, to Guppy's Head. And given the fact that we've got Fishtail means that Jar of Flies is going to be paying out pretty huge for us.
Something's wrong.
So let's stick with Jar of Flies for now, and I'll hold on to the Moon card. Wow, what a series of events that was. Double Steam Sail again. That does not happen very often. So Jar of Flies, what it will do is it will produce an attack fly every time we kill something with our tears. And that caps out at 20. As opposed to Guppy's Head, which just simply caps out at like 5 or so. I always forget the amount that it caps out at. It's not high. But of course the trade-off for that is that you don't need to worry about killing enemies for it, and it's also on every cooldown, on every room. You know, so it's constant protection versus like a burst of protection. And right now we went for the burst of protection route. But again, I know I keep bringing this up, but 3.53 damage, this is what a 3.53 damage run looks like. Where we're relying on the virus and shadow of all things. My shadow to deal stuff. Yera. I think Rune gives us a Yera rune. Burcano. Like Burcano. Get double Alges. The moon. Alges is pretty good here because it allows us to poison enemies. And it's actually pretty nice against the boss as well. because of all the ads that mom spawns. We got a golden bomb, so I can use that offensively as well. Okay. Unless we're in a room where we can't hit them. We have to rely on our distance. Alright, so one thing you should never do with Jar of Flies, you should never let it cap out. And I generally only let the jar get to 20 because we're right before a boss. But something else that's important to keep in mind is that your flies do not generate more flies. So if a target dies by your hand, you get a fly in the jar. But if it dies by a fly, even if it was one spawned in from the jar itself, it does not replicate itself, in other words. No reason for us to use algaes here. We don't need money for anything because we have a double steam sale. Only thing I'm doing is getting down to a half heart so we can get polar invincibility. I mean, I guess I'll take... the only reason why I'm taking Bum Friend is because we don't need money. That's the only reason why you're allowed at this party. So, there's all the flies that we just got. And there they all go. But you saw how many spawned there, and it's significant. And again, that's thanks to Fishtail. There we go. We wanted to jump in the fire. Jump in the Fire by Metallica. Look it up, sweetheart. Somehow that foot wasn't in the fire. Okay. All right, brain. It's time to wake up a little bit here. I mean, I could let her just poison herself over and over again on the virus and gnawed leaf, but really would prefer not to have to do that if I don't have to. No deal with the devil, sad face, and man. Yeah. We gotta head on down. This is rough. Now, if we had enough time to make Hush, one could argue that we should do Hush. Just based on the lack of damage alone, and on top of that, we've got double steam sail. But it cannot be understated of how much we need to get some help here. We are now officially in the late game stages of this run, and we still have abysmal damage, just horrible damage. There's a reason why all the flies and stuff are wasting away so much faster than normally because of the fact that they don't deal enough damage, so they can't effectively take down enemies, which means that the enemies are going to persist longer, and that's longer for them to remove flies from the room, or spiders. That was the second time we've had an animation just not play in recent days. Over here, maybe? Yeah, I'm just gonna nope out of this room. Not even worth my time. Okay. So this boss fight should be very interesting. This room is horrible, by the way. Like, actually horrible. With this damage, this room is a nightmare. Thank God we got the wafer, but good lord, man. Thank you. Oh, good. All right. I'm gonna drop a bomb here on Bloat to hopefully he stays in the fire. If he doesn't, then hopefully I can push him into it. Okay. I mean, I wouldn't mind a movement speed upgrade, but that's not what we want right now. And it's a Krampus fight. Oh. I mean, the head of Krampus is a boss killing item, but I still think the jar of flies is better. I'm gonna stick with jar of flies, but man, this run is very quickly starting to get desperate here. I mean not very quickly, like we are desperate. We are in some serious trouble on this run. Should have known something was up. We didn't get that 68% deal with the devil. I mean, every run that we get is losable. Like, that's not a new concept to anybody. But the fact of the matter is that we got no value out of essentially PhD and double Steam Sale. We got almost nothing. Which is a true shame. Travesty. We could go to the mini boss room, but again, even if it was Ultra Pride, I wouldn't do it. So I'm just trying to get some poison out there. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to let them run into us. Here we go. We could go play the arcade. Let's go see if there's a donation machine in here. There's not, but there's a demon judgment though, which is good. Penny does not help us at all. All right. Well, maybe we will get a non-HP upgrade from this boss. Not boss, judgment. Losing my mind, man. I've been playing Isaac for so long today, I'm going insane. This run is making me go insane. It's gonna go all the way to the right, isn't it? It's gonna make me go all the way to the right. Yep. Oh, it touched the portal. These Diglets, dude. Okay, I mean, it only costs us one soul heart, not two, to get in here. We have a power pill if we need to use it. And there's not really much I can say about this run, man. If anything, this would be one of the most creative wins that we'll get. I quickly darted through there just to try to get some poison going. Wow, we can't even kill this Diglett in, I think that was 7 hits. That's real bad. Am I nervous about this run? I don't know if I would say nervous. I'm not feeling good about it, that's for sure. I don't know. I'm not sure how you could see this run and think, man, that's got to be fun. Or, man, I gotta get some of that action. It's fun whenever you get these kind of runs to try to figure out, okay, where is our path of victory? We want to get off the path to morning. We want to get on the path of victory. An Emperor card would do just fine. Dude. We got over 6.5 luck game. Should help us out with something, right? Right? There you go. Got ourselves a Steam sale. Our Steam sale, God. I'm just done today. This is all Hutz's fault. 100% Hutz's fault. Alright. So get ready for what is quite possibly one of the longest Mom's Heart fight you'll ever hear. We're going to be here a while. Unless if she yeets herself by spawning like Little Horn or something. Again, it's debatable whether or not I should have dropped Guppy's head or not. I think I could have gotten away with Guppy's head and been fine, but oh good. I'm gonna focus on Mom's Heart here. There we go. We need those bombs. The soul said nope. Unfortunately, the soul does not give you immunity from brimstone. As much as that would be cool. Wow, we did it. We went through an entire brimstone cycle, and we got to the other side. And here we go again. Oh, okay. We get a third one. It's good. We got to deal with the devil. Is it good? Oh, you bet your freaking bottom dollar it is. Okay. We did it. If you can stay alive long enough for the game to give you what you need to succeed. And boy, howdy, did we pay for it. We paid for it in spades. Wonder makes you small. Oh my god, a tear's up. Unbelievable. Tears range up as well, I tell you what. Okay, so we got Mom's Knife. Obviously, Mom's Knife is going to help in a huge way. It helps alleviate a lot of the pain that we were experiencing against pretty much every single boss since the first floor. Over here. Black Ragman. I've been seeing some people tweet out pictures of themselves with the Ikoria set from Magic the Gathering. I'm super looking forward to it. Gotta take Yara Rune. Somebody said they pulled Shin Godzilla. I didn't even know that Shin Godzilla was gonna be a card. Secret rooms, got Guppy's collar. Well, we're only one. Thank you, bum friend. We're only one Guppy item away from Guppy. gonna try to bob and weave through here. And sorry about the commentary being so sporadic today. I've had to do a lot of concentrating here. It's just that with the nature of these low damage runs, right, there's not a whole lot to say other than like, okay, well, this is what we got to do here. Let's hope that this happens, or let's hope that this happens. It puts you in a rough spot from a content creator point of view, because it's like, you know, I mean, even with Mom's Knife, like, we're not knocking it out of the park here. But I'm not going to sit here and confidently say that this is, like, still not a one run. I mean, Mom's Knife made this a one run, especially with us having the waiver, especially with us having the virus. All it takes is us finding one good room that has some black flies in it, and we're done. Yeah, thank you very much, Isaac. Oh, yeah, we also have Bum Frame. Bum Frame can also drop some chests in the chest itself. Gonna Yara rune this, and let's just see what we come up with. Sack Daggerino. Where were you so long ago? My goodness. Sack Dagger, you know I love you. You know everyone knows that I love you. But good lord, bro, you needed to show up yesterday. That's how late you are to this party. So we get Sack Dagger, which is going to give us, of course, that much-needed orbital that we wanted. And with us having our Polar Invincibility, and more importantly, the virus, that's going to give us a very easy renewable source of HP, while also dealing damage. You'll notice here that having Sack Dagger is actually more damage than Mom's Knife itself, which is something that I've always maintained. I think Sack Dagger is worth the same amount of damage from Mom's Knife if it were like 13 or something like that. It's a pretty good chunk of damage. Down goes the Chubster. She gives us one soul heart. I'm going to try to use Sack Dagger here. Rafa will let me. Dude, Wrath, man. Oh, okay. We just get blown out of there. This should be a huge, huge, huge boon for our HP. I'm gonna get out and just start Blackheart bombing this entire room. Again, all these dingas, they pay out with dingoles, which then pay out with dips, which could give us potentially way more HP than what we're actually putting into it. Open these, Mom's bra. Bag doesn't really matter. Thank you, Bum Friend. So at the end of the day, it was thanks to our ingenuity with Gnawed Leaf and with the virus that sort of paved the way through here. And then we sent it home with Sack Dagger and Gnawed Leaf. And it feels good, you know? It feels good to get a win like that after struggling for, like, so long on this run. Oh, yeah, that's a funny game. Oh, yeah, no, that's great. X-Zero 2020 Sack Dagger at the very end of a run. That's, especially a run that will look like this. It's quite poetic. So thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you had a great start to your June month, as well as on Tuesday here. If you enjoy this video, please consider clicking the like button. It's the best way to support myself and other content creators here on the platform. If you do happen to see a post-video survey, kindly consider doing it 5 stars. Again, it's the best way to support my channel, and it lets everyone know that you love watching Isaac here in the Mosh Pit, and I thank you all very much for that. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody.